This tutorial will show what a smart snapshot is and how to build it. This is an example of a standard snapshot. We have all of our instruments laid out for the entire set, and we are bypassing unwanted sounds. You will notice that we have three channels that are dedicated to PS keyboards to access the patches that we want. With smart snapshots, this is no longer a problem. Now, let's create a smart snapshot from scratch. First, we will go ahead and clear out the mixer to get rid of these other plugins. Now what we're going to do is lay out all of the plugins we're going to use for the entire bank. In some cases, I think of these as sets for a show. You want to get all of the plugins that you're going to use for them in one multi. You're going to notice that I'm changing each receptor channel to MIDI channel 1. In this case, I'm using a keyboard that is only sending MIDI channel 1, and I want it to affect every receptor channel. This time when I'm building the multi-patch, I'm only going to use one PS keyboard channel. This is where smart snapshots come into play. Side note, I do like to save all of my snapshots and smart snapshots in a regular multi-bank just as a backup, just in case something happens in the future that I need to make a change to. Now that we have a backup saved, I will create a snapshot bank. To do this, you will see that there's a snapshot button just to the right side of the new button in the save file area. You'll notice that the bank will be brown, just like with regular snapshots. Now, what we need to do is save a patch inside the bank. Make sure that the brown snapshot bank is highlighted, and then click the patch tab at the top. Click the save button and enter in a name and click OK to save that patch. Once the patch is saved, you'll return to the mixer. What you need to do now is click on another channel that's not the active one. That will actually refresh the mixer. You'll notice that there will be a new lock next to the bank and patch name up at the source level. This lock is a key feature in smart snapshots. If you click the lock, it will unlock that certain channel or plugin so that you can change between source patches at the snapshot multi-level. This means that I only have to have one instance inside the multi. I can actually sort through different patches at the source level inside that plugin. Now, I will finish building this particular patch and save it as song 1. I will make two more patches while changing the source patch in my unlocked channel. In this case, is PS Keyboards. It's important to know that once you have a channel unlocked or locked, it must stay that way for the entire time spent in that snapshot bank. As I change through the patches, you're going to see that the lock channels stay the same. The unlocked channel, the PS keyboards, are changing through the source patches that I have saved in the snapshot level. One last note. If you have a channel unlocked, the source will reload even if you are using the same source patch between snapshots. Keep this in mind when using sample-heavy plugins like Contact or Ivory.